Hello guys, welcome back to the channel. So in this video I will show you how to write end-to-end script using Amazon's product search example. So before we start, if you don't have subscribed to this channel, then please subscribe and share it to your QA friends. Also watch this video full so understand how things work and how you can write a complete UI automation test using Puppeteer. So let's start. So what exactly our test case is, let me show you using browser. So just I want to hit amazon.com and search something, let's say mobile phones, and now I will make sure like this page get open fully and I will click on next button. In second page I will click on third link. So this third link can be anything, like Amazon don't show every time same phone, so it can be Nokia phone or iPhone, but I don't care. I just need to click on third link of second page of Amazon. So this is what we want to automate. This is the feature I am given to automate. So when you start, before you write the code, just make sure like what all you need to do. So you need to hit the URL, then you need this search box to search something. After search, your job is to wait till this page get loaded, and you need to check like next button is available, then click on this, and you need to click on third link. So to click on third link is tricky part. So how will you do that, because we are not searching this product directly, so this can be anything. So you need to get all the links and then click on third link. So this is how I understand I need to automate. So let's start in our code side. So this is my template looks like. I put some comments about what I am automating, then this basic requirement, and then I am using Mocha framework, so describe and eat. So those who don't know like what is Mocha framework, I already have created the video, so you can watch it later. So I will write the full code of this Amazon search example, and I have given this description, so it will come in my report. So watch this video till the end, so you will get to know how to find XPath, how to put in script, and how end-to-end script will work. So first let me put this comment, let me put same like Amazon search automation. So whenever someone other than you will see this, they come to know, okay, this is the example, this is the what we have automated in this script, and who has automated. So I put author. So I put author and author name, let's say Ankit. So this is how my template is now. So first we need to hit URL. So I will take URL in one of the constant. We can put this I think on top also, so that like whenever some URL get changed for website, you just need to update here. So let's say it's amazon.com's URL, so I need to just copy that. So this is my URL. Now here in it, let's initialize our browser. Don't forget await Puppeteer.launch. So first we need to launch the Puppeteer. So let's launch it in headless mode so that we can see like while debugging if it is working or not. So we are not launching in headless mode, we are launching in headful mode, I think we can say. Now we should have page object, page class object, constant page equal to await browser dot new page. So we need to open new page, right? So you don't need to put semicolons in JavaScript every time, but I am from Java. I learned Java first and now learning JavaScript, so this is my habit. Page dot go. So open a page, you can write separate method also, like open page and put this code in that method or function and call this function here. So every time you just need to update that function whenever there is some issue when hitting the URL in the browser. So here we can put URL. So let's check like if it is hitting or not. So here you see like it's opening this amazon.com. So till now what we have written is working. So here you can see like our description shows here and first test what we wrote shows here. So if you have multiple tests, it write one by one, that also we have in previous videos. So now let's write again ahead. So what we now need to do is we need to type in search box. So let's get the ID of that search box. So I mostly prefer DOM elements, data TID or data test ID. So I always ask developer to put some data TID. So I can directly use data TID, but we have ID, so we can use this ID here. So now we need to type on that. So we can use page.type. And this ID I directly not putting here. I am creating one constant selectors. So here I will put all my selectors. So now let's say search box. Sorry, here my Java skill is coming between JavaScript. So this is what my ID is. So I am putting here ID. So now I will use directly this constant search selectors dot search box. And text I need to pass mobile phones. So now it should type the mobile phones. So let's do that, and after that we can use this window to get further selectors. So now it's mobile phone is clicking, but we need to click here or press enter. So just to get like how keyboard works, I am pressing enter, or you can just click on search button. So await page dot keyboard dot press. So this is how it will click the key. So I can say enter. So it will enter the key. Now after entering, let's say I assume like it will enter the key. So we need to wait till this page loads. So for that we can use some of the class or something to make sure it is opening. But so what happens is sometimes this page is not loaded but internal class is loaded. So always try to use some button or some element. This is concrete on the page. So we need to press on next button next. So I will just waiting for that next button only, so that we make sure like it will work. So it is a last is class name. I am not seeing any identifiers, but you can use IDs or data TIDs if it is added. So let's say my next button. Let's create DOM only with class. there is problem with single inverted comma, because we are using so double inverted comma we can use. So you can make sure like this DOM is working or not. So here you can see control F and pull. Okay, it is identifier and it is only one. So now next button is there. So now I will wait for that. First let me store somewhere, so I need to click on that anywhere. So constant next equal to await page dot wait for selector. So wait for selector waits for that selector till it get loaded. So it wait for I think 30 seconds. So you can use selectors dot next button. So it will now wait for next button. After that, you can next dot click. So it will click on that element. Now it is waited. It went to next button. So again I need to wait till the second page get loaded, right? So I can use same, but I don't need to click on next button, so I can use same like till this button is get loaded. So that means next page get loaded. So after next page get loaded, this page got loaded. Now I need to click on third link. So I need to get all the links. So let's say this is the link. So it is span and it also don't have much identifier, but we can use this. So it is giving me all 22 links. So I will put all, take all the links and put in one of the array and click on third element of that array. So we can use XPath also because it's span, or you can use DOM also. So we already used the DOM here. So let's try with XPath this time. So let's say product links equal to span class equal to this one, and you can use this tilde sign so that it works. It is grammar error. Okay, equal to again. So, and I have to put here comma and here 24. Yeah. So this is how I get all the links, product links in XPath. Now, Puppeteer has a function to wait for XPath page dot wait for XPath. Now I can put this selectors dot wait for X product links. So here it will wait till that XPath is loaded or that links are getting, all the links are getting. Now I can, after this XPath is done, I can store it like a constant product equal to await page dot dollar x. So what this dollar x do is it will get the XPath of the selector. So you can put selector dot project link. So it will give all the XPath, returns all the array of XPath and stored in product. Now you can click on that. So you can do await page dot, not page dot, product dot click. So now product is array, like it has all the array elements. So we need to click on third element. So array start from zero. So you need to put 2, 0, 1 and 2. So it will click on third link. So let's check whatever we wrote is working or not. So let's run this. So it opens Amazon.com, mobile phones, click on next and click on the link. So this time see this is a different mobile but it clicked on that. So now it is working. So now next what we can check is like if it is opening this product page or not. So we can take the screenshot of this and we can have this in one of the folder, or we can print this in logs like title of which product we got on third link. So this is good idea. Let's put ID of this product title. So product title. I need to put comma and putting ID of this one. So we can use this product title and we can print the title in the logs to verify like it has opened the page. First you can wait for if this product is open. So we can wait for product title. So wait page dot wait for element source selector. And here we can pass selector dot product title. So that means product title is loaded. Now I can get product title which dollar evil, and it will help you to get the inner text of the element. So I can pass element. Title and now el, that means element el dot get inner get inner text. So it will give me the inner text. So I can store that at constant title. Do not use first letter capital in variable. Always use camel case. Console.log and you can log the title. Also we can take the screenshot of this await page dot screenshot. There is a direct method in Puppet here. It is like better than Selenium in this way. Can give path and give like a mobile product. You can give name of the screenshot. So it will store at the same path if you didn't provided any external path. So let's run. Okay, so before that I need to give mobile product dot png. So please type. Now it should run. So it is searching, clicking on the link and you are getting this link. So I didn't use browser dot close, so it didn't close automatically. This should be put in after always, so that after the test case is finished, browser get close. So this is how it is running end to end. Okay, we are not getting this text, it is getting undefined this one, so we need to check. So why we are getting undefined here? Because I am using el.get inner text. It is like el.inner text. So now it will get the inner text of the DOM we have given. In our case, it's product title. So now we will get the title and then so we are printing the log. So to make sure like it is giving correct one, you can always use assert or equal expect, so that you should say like it assert that it is not equal to undefined, so you are getting some title there. So now this should work. So I will put this code in my blog, so go to that blog, follow that blog also, and I have put it the link in the description. Also all my social media links are in description. I occasionally put memes there, so those who are interested in that, you can like my page, follow on Twitter. Please subscribe this channel. For any doubt, you can put the put comments here, or you can directly contact me on social media. Thank you.